Imagine waiting for a new lung or kidney transplant. You finally get one, go through intense surgery, and then after a few years, your body's like, nope, I don't like this thing, get it out, and rejects that vital organ. Heartbreaking, right? Transplant rejection happens, and more often than you'd think. About 50% of all transplanted organs are rejected within 10 to 12 years. That is a staggering number. Organ rejections happen at the molecular level. Something just isn't compatible, and finally, scientists think they've uncovered the basis of this response. This is a metaphorically huge but literally microscopic thing, so we have to understand how the body deals with a foreign lung or liver or whatever, and that relationship starts at the immune system level. So let's say you're getting a new kidney. That is a whole ecosystem of living things, and it's alien. The immune system knows this because the cells on the donor organ are different. But once it knows, it's definitely not going to ignore it. As far as the immune system is concerned, it could be a giant virus or poison. So it tries to get rid of it. Your immune system is designed to attack anything it doesn't recognize. And there are two main parts within the immune system that are responsible for this 1-2 punch: the innate immune system and the adaptive immune system. The adaptive immune system response is what you think of when you think immune system. This is DEFCON 1. White blood cells are ready to attack the invader. But white blood cells don't just attack anything, they need a snitch. They need to be told what to attack. That's what's been elusive for scientists, the triggers for the innate immune system response. How do the T cells get fired up enough to attack your shiny new organ? Bear with me, we're about to get real molecular. In a paper published in Science Immunology, they found that T cells won't launch an offensive unless another immune cell called a dendritic cell yells, "Intruder alert!" Dendritic cells are on the lookout for a molecule called SIRP-alpha. If your kidney is put in my body, the SIRP-alpha don't match. When they aren't a match, the receptor on a monocyte called CD47 binds to that SIRP-alpha protein. The monocytes are another type of immune cell. Once that binding happens, the dendritic cell rings the alarm and the big guns roll in, and that's what causes organ rejection. Basically, a protein interaction sets off a chain reaction that eventually leads to bye-bye kidney. The exciting part of this nitty-gritty molecular discovery is that researchers think they can block the interaction between the SIRP-alpha and CD47. Basically, the monocytes never get bound up, so the immune system stays cool. This could prevent organ rejection and lead to acceptance, but more research is needed. Plus, now that we know to look for it, we can match the SIRP-alpha from donors and recipients, possibly causing lower organ rejection rates overall. Being on a list for an organ for years only to have it rejected is devastating for the recipient, but think about it, maybe that kidney could have worked in someone else. The more we know about this process, the better we'll be able to get organs to their forever homes and keep them safe inside the crazy neighborhood that is the human body. Special thanks to our sponsor, Domain.com. When you buy a domain name from Domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. Get 15% off Domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use coupon code SEEKER at checkout. It's hard enough to transplant a single organ, but some scientists are actually trying to transplant a human head, or I guess a whole human body. Check out our video about it right here. Do you guys have any burning science questions you want us to answer? Let us know down in the comments. Be sure to like this video and subscribe so you never miss an episode of Seeker.